Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Earlier this morning, SpaceX launched another Falcon 9 rocket with a Starlink payload for the Starlink 4-18 mission.
One, full power, and lift off.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1052, then landed successfully for the fifth time on the drone ship in shortfall of gravitas.
Legs will deploy here shortly. Let's see if Falcon 9 can touch down.
Stage one, landing leg deploy.
Incredible view there. As you can see on your screen, Falcon 9 has touched down on our drone ship.
Stage one landing confirmed.
A short fall of gravitas. Now this marks the 121st overall recovery of a Falcon booster.
Forte would share this article saying Uzbekistan is trying to woo Starlink and OneWeb to bring their satellite broadband services to Central Asia's most populous country. Ranking officials recently met with the Starlink and OneWeb representatives in the country's capital, Tashkent, asking for their satellite broadband services to be made available in Uzbekistan. Eric Berger posted an interesting tweet saying SpaceX is now about 85% vertically integrated, sources say. This is not entirely by choice, but as supply chain problems have arisen, the company has re-evaluated work that had previously been outsourced and brought some of it in-house. There's an article about a Falcon Heavy launch that has been pushed back a tad bit. It says, in March, EchoStar announced its Hughes network system had selected SpaceX to launch the Maxar-built Jupiter 3 geostationary communications satellite during an industry conference. During that announcement, the company said the satellite would launch in the fourth quarter of 2022. Now, due to delays to the numerous Maxar spacecraft, the satellite will launch no earlier than early 2023. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. Crews continue to work on the chopstick catching arms. Further work has also been continuing with the structural test stand. As well as that, work continues on the orbital launch mount. A new gate has been installed at the launch site. This new SPMT was spotted delivered. The Megabay is near enough complete at this point with two prototypes inside as well. Somebody by the name of Farayel flew over the Roberts Road facility in Florida and posted some pictures of the progress. SpaceX now have five of the orbital launch integration tower segments pretty much ready. I believe they are also doing groundwork for a building to be constructed. The chopped off Ship 16 nose was sitting outside the Megabay. As you probably expected, the nose cone is now being scrapped. Also, the tank section has been moved out of the Megabay. Ship 24 is continuing to be worked on inside the high bay. Starship 24 has now received body flaps. A Starship liquid oxygen stack was spotted that will be for either Ship 25 or Ship 26. Raptor 2s have started being moved into the Megabay for B7 installation. The Booster 8 liquid oxygen tank section was moved back into the high bay. This section was then stacked with another liquid oxygen section in the high bay. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary or Boca Chica girl and Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.